It seems as if every younger director wants to be George Lucas, so it's definitely noteworthy when you get one who wants to be Garson Kanin. The breakup is the newest by Peyton Reed, who did the Doris Day pastiche Down with Love. And this time, he's trying to channel the old Tracy Hepburn comedies using a more modern model, an amiable Polish slob, Vince Vaughn, who's a video game-addled overgrown kid who always seems to be talking through a mouthful of food, and a gallery owner's assistant, Jennifer Aniston. The two split up over a basically silly argument, but too much pride and a too valuable condo keep them from moving out on one another.
Can I get 6 hot dogs down here, please?
Right away.
And make it right, please. You know, with the mustard and the ketchup and the relish. And don't make me hit you up for more.
I thought we were going wiener circle after those. Do them. Why are you in hot dogs?
Pass this down, please.
You
can keep the change. Do you want one of the hot dogs? You can have a hot. You want a hot dog? Do you want a hot dog, miss?
No, thank you. That's okay.
Go ahead, you can have a hot dog.
No, I don't want
one. Do you mind passing the lady one of the hot dogs?
I'm good.
You can have your own.
Really
here.
Nice of you. Please. I really don't. Okay, give me a hot dog.
Can we give her a hot
Thanks.
Dog?
Thanks.
I got the big guy can't eat all of them. Have one. Have you ever had one before?
A hot dog?
At the ballpark.
I believe I have.
Okay, good.
Thanks.
Well, enjoy this one.
Thanks.
Do you like mustard?
No, I'm okay.
It's much better with the topping. Here. I'm just kidding. I'll give you two.
That's absolutely not what the clip will look like in the theater. You know,
the color's better.
Technical trouble, yeah. Well, the color is the color better. I mean, I think one of the first lines of attack on this movie, I'd say, is that in the theaters, the color resembles Eastman color.
Uh-huh.
It resembles a really old and inferior color process. It's odd to me that we have two films set in Chicago, and that they try to flaunt the buildings, the architecture of the noble city.
Right.
And the second one, which we'll talk about in a minute, is so much better at it. I mean, Vince Vaughn is supposed to be a tour guide, and yet you see so little of Chicago, so much of this takes place in that condo, and those right. four walls close in on you. What did you think, Mort?
Oh, I thought this film was dreadful. Was it a comedy? I mean, it was ugly.
It was ugly.
And it's just really nastiness between people. But I got to tell you, Vince Vaughn is an actor I love, but he's a very strange kind of actor because he's so abrasive.
Yeah.
You know? And the big question I had right from the beginning is, he is such a pig.
Yeah.
When he meets her,
yeah.
suddenly they're living together. Why did she ever start in with this guy to begin with? Because he's doing the same thing after they're together. And then, what is it, a year or two or three later, she decides she's going to walk out.
She finally decides, yeah, over a ridiculous argument about how he's not bringing home a dozen lemons.
Right.
It's I guess, with low-hard qualities or something like that. Jennifer Aniston, as I like to call her, is inert once again.
Mm-hmm.
The supporting cast is strangely wasted. There's Anne Margaret in this, and
yes,
Judy,
for a moment,
the great Australian actress Judy Davis is.
But who has her great moment? She does have one scene, and they must have promised her that.
They
promised one other terrific member of the cast, which is Vincent D'Onofrio.
Vincent D'Onofrio did have a good scene in here too. I mean, they
good
really
two scenes.
Well, you know, that's the beauty of being a character actor. You know, your part's going to be okay. Otherwise, though, this is almost a total waste. It's ugly and
it's
depressing.
When you have broken up with someone and it is a real ugly breakup, you want to see what you look like. Go to see this film.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.